Dear students, welcome to my classroom. In the previous part of the chapter real numbers, we solved all the problems in exercise 1.1. And in today's class, we are going to learn a new concept, irrational numbers. So students, what are irrational numbers? Let us discuss. We know that if x square equal to 4, then the value of x equal to plus or minus root 2, isn't it? If we square plus root 2 plus 2, we get 4, and if we square minus 2, then also we get 4. So if x square equal to 4, then the value of x is plus or minus 2. And similarly, if x square equal to 9, then x equal to plus or minus 3. And if x square equal to 2, then what is the value of x? So if you take square root on both sides, then square root of x square is equal to square root of 2. That means in the square root of x square, square and root will be cancelled. Then we left with x equal to plus or minus root 2. But what is the value of root 2 here? Is there any rational number satisfying this equation? Do you think so? No. That is, by squaring any number, we can't get the value of 2 in rational numbers. So there is no number satisfying this equation in rational numbers, isn't it? That is, root 2 is not a rational number because there is no rational number satisfying this equation here. So root 2 is not a rational number. That means we cannot express root 2 in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q not equal to 0. So, we know that the numbers which can be expressed in the form p by q are called rational numbers. But here, root 2 cannot be expressed in the form of p by q, so that root 2 is not a rational number. So, the numbers which cannot be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q not equal to 0, are called irrational numbers. What are irrational numbers? The numbers which cannot be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q not equal to 0, are called irrational numbers. Okay, that is the definition of irrational numbers. The rational numbers can be expressed in the form of p by q, and the irrational numbers cannot be expressed in the form of p by q. But here, what is the value of root 2? How to find the value of root 2? So, let us find the value of root 2 up to 4 decimals only. Now, let us find the value of square root of 2 up to 4 decimals. As we are going to find the square root of 2 up to 4 decimals, the number of zeros after decimal point we have to take is twice the number of decimals in the square root of 2 that we are going to find. That is, as we are going to find the square root of 2 up to 4 decimals, we have to take 8 zeros after decimal point of 2. So, 2.00000000. That is, we are taking 8 zeros after decimal point. Now, group the zeros after decimal point into pairs like this. And we have only one number before decimal point, So take that one number as one group. Now we know that the perfect square less than 2 is 1. So and 1 is 1 into 1 is 1. So 1 1's are 1. So now subtract 1 from 2, we get 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Now write down the pair of zeros after decimal point. So as we are going to write down the zeros after decimal point, take decimal point in our result. Now write down the pair of zeros. Okay. Now add 1 to 1. Then 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Now let us see in which number 100 will be go. So we know 21 ones are 21, 22 twos are 44, 23 threes are 69, 24 fours are 96, and 25 fives are 125. But 125 is more than 100. So we need to take 24 fours are 96. So take 24 fours are 96. Now again subtract 96 from 100. We get 100 minus 96 is equal to 4. Now again write down one pair of zeros. Okay. Now again add the value of 4 to this 24. So 24 plus 4 is 28. Now let us check in which number 400 will be go. So we have 281 into 1 is 281, 282 into 2 is 564, but 564 is more than 400. So we need to take 281 ones are 281. So 281 ones are 281. Now again subtract 281 from 400. So 400 minus 281 is equal to 119. Now add the 1 to 281. Before that write down the zeros, pair of zeros. So 11,900, and now add 1 to 281, this 1 to 281. So 281 plus 1 is 282. Now we have 2821 into 1 is 2821, and 2822 into 2 is 5064. In that way we get 2824 into 4 is equal to 11,296, and if you take 2825 into 5, 14,125, which is greater than 11,900. So that we have to take 2824 into 4 is equal to 11,296, like this. That is, we have to take same number in left side and right side. So now subtract it. So the result is 604. Now again write down the next pair of zeros, that is the last pair of zeros. Now add 4 to 2824. So 2828. Now again we have 28,282 into 2 is 56,564, which is less than 60,400, but 28,283 into 3 is 84,849, which is greater than 60,400. So we need to take 28,282 into 2 is equal to 56,564. Now again subtract, we get 3,836. So now the zeros after decimal point are ended. Now we left with 1.4142 after on the right side. So the square root of 2 up to 4 decimals only is 1.4142. But we continue this process, then the process will be going on infinitely. Okay, so in that way we get the value of root 2 as 1.41421352637311 up to infinity. We get the value of root 2 like this. And similarly, the value of root 3 is 1.73205080756789 and so on. So these are non-terminating and non-recurring decimals. So no group of numbers are repeating, and the division is running continuously. So these are non-terminating and non-recurring decimals. Okay, so we cannot express these numbers in the form p by q. So these are known as irrational numbers and denoted by q dash or s. We denote the rational numbers by q, but these numbers are denoted by q dash. The irrational numbers are denoted by q dash or s. Okay, now root 1 is 1, root 2 is 1.41421 35, like that. Root 3 is 1.73205080 something up to infinity, and root 4 is 2, and this is the right value of root 5, this is the value of root 6, this is the value of root 7, and this is the value of root 8. And we know root 9 is 2. So by observing all these, we can say that root 1, root 4, root 9 are rational numbers, because 1, 2 and 3 can be expressed in the form of p by 2. That is 1 is equal to 1 by 1, 2 is 2 by 1, 3 is 3 by 1, like that. But here root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, root 7, root 8 are non-terminating and non-recurring decimals. That is, we can't express these numbers in the form of p by q. So root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, root 7, root 8 are irrational numbers. Okay, students. So in general, if n is a natural number other than a perfect square, then root n is an irrational number, isn't it? So we have 1, 4, 9 are perfect squares, and root 1 is 1, root 4 is 2, root 9 is 3, and 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8 are not perfect squares. In this case, we got root n as irrational number. So whenever n is a natural number other than a perfect square, then root n is an irrational number. Okay. Now let us discuss about pi. Students, we know that the perimeter of a circle having radius r is c equal to pi d, where d is equal to 2 into r. C equal to 2 pi r, that is pi into 2 r, and 2 r is the diameter of the circle. So perimeter of the circle is c equal to pi d. Now from this we can write pi equal to c by d. So now what is the value of pi? Is the pi is rational or irrational? Here it is, seems like pi is a rational number because it is in the form p by q, that is c by d, isn't it? It seems like that pi is a rational number. But there does not exist a common unit to measure that allows us to measure the both numerator and denominator. And if you measure accurately, then at least either c or d is irrational. So pi is regarded as irrational. Okay, so pi is an irrational number. So the value of pi is 3.1415926535897932384626, like that. So the decimal expansion of pi is non-terminating and non-recurring. So pi is an irrational number. Okay. So we often take the value of pi is 22/7, but it is an approximate value only, not exact value of pi. Okay, the approximate value of pi is 22/7. It is not the exact value of pi. Now let us see how to represent irrational numbers on number line. We know that root 2, root 3, root 5, these are irrational numbers. So now let us see how to represent the root 2 on number line. So first take the number line of integers 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, and for our convenience, I am dividing the portion of the integers between portion between the integers into 5 equal parts like this. Now each part represents 0.2, that is after 0, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, after that 1, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, like that. Now take a line segment of length 1 unit, which is represented by OA. Now OA is the line segment of length 1, and now draw a line segment of length 1 unit perpendicular to OA, like this. OA is 1 unit and AB is 1 unit. AB is perpendicular to OA. Now join O and B. Now what is the length of OB? According to Pythagoras theorem, square on the hypotenuse of a right-angled triangle is equal to sum of the squares of remaining two sides. That is, here the length of OB is square root of 1 square plus 1 square. That is root 2. Now the length of OB is root 2. Now draw an arc with center O and OB as the radius, like this. Then the point where the arc cuts the line of integers is represents 2, root 2. So that is the location of root 2 on number line. Okay, in this way we represent root 2 on the number line like this. And if we want to represent root 3, then take a line segment of 1 unit perpendicular to OB, like this. Now BC is perpendicular to OB and the length of BC is 1. Now join OC. Now what is the length of OC? Square root of root 2 square plus 1 square, that is root 3. Now the length of OC is root 3. To locate root 3 on this number line, draw an arc of radius OC and with center O, like this. So this is the position of root 3, where the arc cuts the number line, the point is the position of root 3. Okay, so in this way we can represent any irrational number on this number line. If we want to represent root 5, we need to remember that root 2 square plus 1 square equal root 5. Then we take the length of OA as 2 and AB as 1, then we get under root 2 square plus 1 square equal root 5. And similarly, if we want to locate root 10, then we take the length of OA as 3, then root 3 square plus 1 square equal root 10, like that. Okay. Now let's go for real numbers. Our chapter real numbers. What is real numbers? The collection of all rational and irrational numbers is called real numbers. We know that rational numbers are represented. Rational numbers can be expressed in the form p by q, and irrational numbers cannot be expressed in the form p by q. That is, all the type of numbers are covered in real numbers. Okay, and real numbers denoted by capital letter R. So examples: -5.6, √21, -2, 0, 1, 1/5, 22/7, pi, √2, √7, √9, 12.5, 12.5, 1, 2, 3, and so on up to. All these are examples for real numbers. Okay, students, and in next class we shall discuss deeply about real numbers. Until then, see you. Bye.